Okay, welcome to everybody to this third meeting. So the idea of today is to help you organizing a certain number of groups as you want. In a group you can develop something. I have seen here in Jamboard that there are people proposing a podcast or a presentation or an investigation about TikTok. So I agree with all these proposals. I remember that you can also eventually evaluate in a comparative way other products, for instance, other podcasts, video on YouTube, articles, communication. So you are free. So the idea is to develop either try to develop a product so that you can appreciate the work which is behind such a product, or develop an interpretation or an evaluation of something already done. So you can continue to work on Jamboard if you want, so that near so after some minutes, we shall present quickly something, and then I can open rooms so that you can discuss live, so speaking each other for the group. So when you have an idea of how many group you want to form, I can open rooms and assign you to the different rooms here. And
So the
the
idea
money
is to
could be
work.
used. No. Okay, go.
So the idea is to work now a little bit to understand what you want to develop and in the week. Because,
Yeah,
Franco,
you.
remember, we have other
We
one
have
other.
the last lesson next Monday. So
Yeah.
I would like that you work a little more in this week so that you can present something which has no
Something
pretension
not so,
to be the final product. Just an idea. It is sufficient to
The
have an
idea.
idea what you want to do so that we can discuss and say, okay, I suggest to improve this aspect or
Yes,
whatever.
no, just to
But
understand the
next
schedule
Monday,
time.
I would like to give you the word and to discuss with you. So according to the number of groups, it can be 15 minutes each or something like this. Okay. So before going on, I would like to Giovanna to present very quickly the tool Audacity, which is
Okay.
a free audio tool for say assembling audio. Maybe some of you already know it. Let me know in the chat if you already know this tool, but it's quite useful. We use it for assembling the radio transmission that we prepare, and so you can clearly use it if you want to develop something in audio. And then I shall quickly show you StreamYard, which is another tool that we use for our science cafe, and which also can be used both for streaming on, say, on YouTube. And then, for instance, we could try a little streaming now just to have an idea of how it works. And you can also use it for recording things, so that if you want to record something with a bit of director, say, change of cameras and so on, StreamYard could be one tool. There are many others, but just for showing you something that you can use. So, Giovanna, if you can, in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, show, for instance, the last issue of Radio Mocha. Unfortunately, the audio will be essentially in Italian, but you can explain how to move to manage it. And
So
meanwhile, try to form the groups so that in half an hour I can open the rooms for you.
Franco, there are no all the participants yet. Do you have someone waiting?
I don't see anybody in
Okay,
waiting room.
just know. because there are 70 people now, so 15. So, okay, I just share the screen so everybody can see. Audacity is a free software that we use to make our radio transmission. It's for sound. It all, you can register, edit, and develop sound. So you can see it's very easy to work with it. You can have many, I don't know, line, one for one instrument in case of music. In our case, we use for different things. For example, the first and the second lines is are for the our intro. So I can just
you can put the song the intro. If you want. If you want to
sorry.
Play only one track, you select a solo here in the track.
Yeah. But it's you can see that in this case, this is our program. We have the first two lines is for the intro. We have here, we have a line for a chat between me and Franco, introducing the first interview, and another chat introducing the second interview. The second interview is inside non ho rubrica. come si può dire?
The
sub probing that we call pills of science, and there is the intro, the second interview, and so on. But I just want to start to you to how to use. You can just play.
I don't see anything. Eh? I don't hear anything.
Yeah? You can listen.
No, I cannot see anything. I think you have to do, or either to have the audio in the line.
Sorry, Franco.
No, because it displays audio in your headset.
But I it's not now, it doesn't work. So I don't understand.
Do you have a headset plugin or
no?
No. Huh. So let's try to play. Okay. Now we.
Okay. Can you listen?
Yes.
Huh? Okay. So this is our intro, and the second line is the voice. Then...
L'Associazione Culturale Caffescienza Firenze e Nova Radio presentano Radio Moca con Franco Bagnoli e Giovanna Pacini.
So, what can you do? You can just visualize in a zoom way, in and out, for a sound. You can decide to for example to cut just throw away, or you can decide to make something for the with the effect. There are some effects, sorry, I okay, like for example you can compress the sound. And it is very useful because many times, for example, for me and Franco, we have two different type of voice, and Franco is higher than me. So it's very important to...
Louder.
Alto.
Più forte, più alta, non più alta di tono, louder.
Louder. And me, and so you have to compress the sound, make
compress the range of the sound. It does not compress the sound. It shortens the range of the sound.
Buongiorno Franco. Buongiorno Franco.
You can also amplify or in this way you can make the sound.
Buongiorno Franco, buongiorno, ci sei? Sei qui?
Not so high, and on the contrary. So you can have many, many effects. Like for example, we don't use, but you can also use the change the time of the sound. Like for example, I want just to show you, just to understand how it works.
Buongiorno Franco, buongiorno, ci sei? Sei qui? Buongiorno a tutti, terza puntata, undicesima stagione.
So, you can see, you can make almost everything with the sound. We always use not so many effects. We use the effects just to, come si può dire?
You can show how to fade in or fade out.
Fade in and fade out, exactly. You can just fade in and fade out. There is an effect, or you can do by yourself. So you can use the fade in, and you can see that in an automatic way.
Okay. Maybe you select the less, a smaller portion.
Yeah. Me, or you can use this type of tool. You can put two or three points and you can manage it just to obtain the same thing. I use always this because you can manage from yourself.
And moreover, because you can revert and came back to the original one in case of So you can say
obviously you can just move your sound, sorry. So you can move with these. With these you can just go inside. And so
that's true.
You can register a new sorry Franco, but it's very important. Mm-hmm. If you want, you can register. It's important because if you, for example, you want to make a podcast or a radio transmission, maybe it's important to register in, and it's easy to register in.
No, you can cut. Can you show how to cut out a piece?
Yeah. So if I want to cut, I use this tool. I just take this and put away. So it's very easy to, but it's very easy to use. Just start to use if you want to put another line, you can another track, you can use this one. The track can be stereo or mono as you want. We use mono track because it's more easy and it's not useful to
use. Voice. We have almost no music in our.
And at the end, you can save.
You can import audio, for instance, not only from other audio file, but also from movie or any.
In the last version of Audacity, I think you have to add something to library to do it.
Yeah, you have to add some.
It's very easy. I did it so, but yeah, and you can save the project like Audacity project, and so remain in that way with all the tracks and so on. Or you can, for example, export your project in an MP3, WAV, OGG, and so on. So you can just do everything you want. It's very easy to use, and if you need some support, you can just direct me, and we can work together on it. So it's not a problem. I'm here. I will be here all the week, so don't worry. Just ask for me, and I can help you.
Yes, there are similar programs also for video, but unfortunately, not say cross platform. Maybe there is something, but not very used. While Audacity runs on say Windows, Macintosh, Linux, and
yeah,
all
so
for the video, for instance, you can interrupt if you want. For instance, in Macintosh, we use a lot iMovie. Let me see. Non è questo. Condivido lo schermo. Here it is. So iMovie, here is for instance a lesson. In some sense it is similar. I have no very sophisticated projects, only say essentially single track ones. So for instance, this is an even simpler project in which we have just one illustration. But let me see, for instance, this is a lesson about statistical physics. And the idea is quite similar. You may increase the resolution, you can cut pieces, and you can say put maybe here figures above or replacing, or you can put the picture in picture. So for instance, an illustration of something while there is slides that changes maybe in lower resolution. So these are just lessons, so not very sophisticated.
Maybe something, I don't know, maybe something
I don't have here a project because I cleaned up. For instance, this is just a clip. So you can have some effects like, say, zooming in some part or adding subtitles like this one. And I think that the similar projects are similar tools. This is a more complex tool. We developed this for telling how we managed to switch to online science cafes due to the COVID. So in this case, you see, we have a separate audio track, a video track, and another video track here, which replaces this one with some effect. A running headline in the bottom, and so an image, then a series of pictures, and then other animations, and finally another thing, some images. So you can construct things like this. Clearly, if you need the help, I'm not an expert, but if you need the help, I'm here. Clearly, if there are questions, you can ask, even though I don't see the chat, but maybe you can tell me if there are questions. And the other thing that I would like to show you is StreamYard. So StreamYard,
yes,
is a tool for streaming, essentially, on YouTube or
there is a sorry Franco, there is a Nastasia that asked to be,
yes, let me, if I'm able to to see the chat, because here when I share the video, I don't see how to see the chat. So let me stop the video. So Anastasia chiede di poter entrare. Ok. Anastasia. Ok, I hope she will be able to enter. I see. Ok, Anastasia, are you in? Yes, seems so, yes. So, let us try, for instance, to set up a quick test of a streaming.
Just explain.
I would like to
StreamYard
working by doing, you know. So,
okay.
The StreamYard, you can use a StreamYard without paying anything. We paid, so as a...
Devo partecipare, devo fare. Le cose dei CF1.
Anastasia?
Sì,
Anastasia, switch off your audio. Ok. So StreamYard is a platform for doing things like this, like Caffè Scienza, like our cafe or others, for instance.
Aspetta, Anastasia, continuiamo a sentire.
Anastasia, I switch off the...
Grazie, già è obbligata a partecipare, vai, andiamo avanti.
So, you can, this was the last Science Cafe 2 days ago, so you can have all people, more people, up to 10, I think, participating. You can see also the...
No, non hai lo schermo condiviso, scusami Franco.
Sorry, this one. So this is the recording of one Science Cafe in last Thursday, I think. So here is the beginning with the participant and the moderator. Then you have several ways of showing people if they discuss, or when there is just one participant, you can have a small icon with the slide, or the slide, the full screen, and so on. And the important thing is that you can also use this tool just for recording. If you want to record something, for instance, Astronauticast, if you look, I think on YouTube, Astronauticast and also Fantascientificast is recorded live. So here are all together, but in general they are, some from Dresden, some from Verona, some from Duisburg, and they record the podcast.
Stagione 14, episodio numero 2. 2 come i conduttori di questa puntata, ma andiamo con ordine.
And so this is also distributed as an audio podcast, but it is recorded using this tool. And so you can have both a video podcast on YouTube and an audio podcast at the same time if you want. And it can be useful both for streaming or just for recording if you are, not in the same location. So you cannot use, share the microphone. You have to interact through the web. So I can show very quickly how to use.
How they can use just to enter to.
Yes, for enter.
StreamYard.com. Okay, sorry, Franco.
Just go here, and if you are not
logged,
if you are not registered, you just ask for a code. You don't have to give that.
We can see, Franco. There is another window, probably we can see.
I don't, Today I'm not able to share the screen. I don't know why, only Windows. That's very mysterious. Generally I can share the whole window.
Okay.
So you just put some address now. So let me try with one which is not probably. And I don't know. This is okay. So if it is not known, they send you a code with that you can enter without say giving much more than just the email address. And when you are in, let me switch it to the other.
Thank you.
Okay. And let me show you. I hope it is this one. Then you can create a broadcast and say you can on YouTube or you have a number of choices here. Say Twitch, Periscope, YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, but you can select a number according if you pay or you don't pay. So at least one it is available, probably two. So this is just a try. You can see, so let me just see how to works here. And then you can enter. So now I am in some sense the director and I can admit people. And so I put the link on the chat if I'm able. This is not easy here.
Zoom. You put the Gmail chat with me, I can put in the chat.
Mm-mm. Okay, so you see this?
Yeah.
Okay.
I need
if some of you want to enter, I can admit it, him. Now you can also maybe let me see on YouTube. We have not yet started the streaming. And then I also can share the YouTube. So through Giovanna, I can share also the YouTube link. So you can either follow directly here or see what will get out by YouTube. So Giovanna, maybe you can enter.
Just mute. I just
want to enter.
I enter. Okay. I'm entering in the studio.
Okay, so this is Giovanna. I can add her to the stream. I can also put your microphone off, Giovanna, or here. Clearly, then I can clearly from here, I can share, say, a screen or a presentation or something like this. No, I think it is myself. Let me mute also myself. And so we can say speak on showing something, in this case, my other screen. And I can be alone with a small small presentation. And we can go just when I set up the test, I can say that I want to stream or just record. But if you want to stream, if I go live now, if you look at the YouTube channel, you should see probably, I don't know if this is the right one.
Yes, just a time.
With some delay, okay, here we are, and we are now.
I asked to the attendees to come in StreamYard, but seems that no one wants to join us.
This is a tool that can be also used for instance, for doing something simple. We have some options to put a logo, a video clip just for starting and ending, to write down something that you can customize and so on. So that's all. We can add some background and so on. It is a simple, but it can be useful to do something. So now it is more with a lot of gadgets inside. Okay, I think that this is enough for the presentation. Let me end the broadcast. So that we essentially, after that, we remove it from YouTube, otherwise other public will think that...
Giovanna, ti pregherei di uscire perché sta arrivando la nostra ospite, farla un po' accomodare. Prego, entri.
This is...
Oh, ecco qua. Oggi, per le interviste impossibili, riceviamo questa...
It's me or you?
Scorso, abbiamo...
No, I think it's you.
It was an interview. Okay. So that's all.
I hope that our attendees are okay, because no one seems to. If you have questions or something else, because I think that StreamYard is very useful. Just if you want to make just a video to show to someone else, or just an interview, a conversation, meeting, and we can use also for seminar, webinar, and so on. So it's a very useful software. So, who is it?
Okay, I think this is enough. It is up to you now to say what you want to. So how many room should I open so that who wants to be in?
Franco, maybe we can have just a look to Jamboard to understand
okay, this is
the number of room, the ideas. Okay, thank you so much.
So I see one group about the podcast. 68 in Italia,
proveniente da Firenze, Santa Maria Novella.
Who is
someone is near the station.
Maybe it is the podcast. Can be.
No. No one can tell you that. Okay.
Okay, so I see group one here.
Group one, group three, group two is about podcasts. So we have many groups of.
Okay, why not? We can prepare more podcast. Yeah. And there is a video presentation. This can be removed now. TikTok, fake news. So there are two or three podcasts. One video. This study about TikTok and the study, or I don't know what, about fake news, maybe discussion. So let me know how you want to be divided.
I think that we can just make a post here, post it, putting one for podcast. A parte il podcast 1 non è stato definito cosa vogliono fare.
Vabbè. Anastasia, can you illustrate what you want to do?
Topico Anita, no? dice il topic di Anita era buono.
I'm here.
Okay, Anastasia. Oh. Can you say launch your idea of a podcast and then I add you to a room?
Yes, we have an idea. We have a lot of ideas, but we met before on another platform, mm-hmm. and we are trying to understand how to work as better as we can.
Okay, you can also self-organize. You are not obliged to use Zoom. So, Anastasia, can you tell us who is inside your group?
Yes, Lorenzo Marini.
Marini.
Anastasia. Anita Nencioni.
Nencioni.
Emilia Innocenti.
Mm-hmm.
Emanuele Guerrini e Andrea Genangeli.
Perfect. Okay, so you are how do you think to develop your podcast?
We were thinking
the others can participate, it's not a discussion among just me and you. So if there are someone of this group, I saw that also Alessandro Vinciguerra was interested in podcast, or maybe you, Alessandro, you are here, no? So maybe you could propose another. So Anastasia, let's finish. Which is the subject, if you have found one of your
podcast? We're trying to understand the best subject because we thought about Drosophila melanogaster, mm-hmm. as a clinic model, or we thought about inquinamento idrogeologico, non so dirlo in inglese.
Idrogeological pollution.
Okay. Then, guys, help me. I don't remember everything.
Yeah. So we have also hypothesized to discuss also. Inquinamento, pollution in general, or climate change strategy of adaptment, invasive species or risk of agricultural soil, I don't know. But we stay still in discuss to choose the topic.
Uh-huh. Okay, so do you think that you can produce something for next week?
Yeah, we
try. Let's try. And have you, what kind of platform or tool do you think to use? Because I think you are working at distance.
Yes, of course. So we wondering about podcast in particular with an impossible interview. Mm-hmm. I don't know which are some charter that is
more suitable for this impossible interview.
Yeah, with climate change, maybe with I don't know some character, historical character that stay in historic age. Climate change doesn't didn't appear.
Yes. I remember that in the movie by Al Gore, An Unfortunate Truth, or something like this, he remembered that there was a researcher in the Hawaii who first started measuring the level of CO2 in the atmosphere. I don't remember if it is James Hansen or I don't know. And also Lovelock, who developed the model Gaia, if I remember well, was one of the first to suggest that there could be a human influence on climate. So maybe one of these could be, but you go on.
We just podcast, and there was also an hypothesis to make a video, but we think about that podcast is more easier than
I think than so.
Construction video.
And for so, sure, you can do in Italian.
Yes, clearly.
Okay, thank you.
You can work in Italian.
For sure, you work in Italian for this. So sorry for.
I don't know if you need the room here in Zoom, I can open one for you, but clearly if you are already organized for using a Meet or some other tool, you can continue. Okay. And clearly we are at your disposal for helping. And so I think you have to quickly decide if you want something like Astronauticas, I mean, a forum where people in discuss about a topic, presenting something. If you want to prepare an impossible interview, you have to write down some text, or other tool, is up to you. Okay, so let's consider another group. If you want to add something, clearly I'm ready here. Anche Alessandro Vinciguerra in this group. Maybe a little too many. You could also think to produce two different products if you want to split, but it's up to you. So this podcast is the same. There is another group three podcast about hormones. Claudia Ravaldi e Giada Crescioli. Giada was here, no? Yes.
Yes, we are both here. Mm-hmm. We wondered about the podcast because it's a thing that I think we didn't do in the past. So it's new for us. It could be interesting, I suppose. I've also Movie Maker. A good tool to do a podcast. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So, yeah. So I saw that you already have found a topic, no?
Yes.
It is still this humor in pregnancy.
Yes, and it's important, Franco. So. Please, I like the topic, please.
Thank you, Giovanna. We also like the topic.
Yes, so, if it's possible. Speak about humor, sometimes it's very important. So please, please.
Okay, so how did you elaborate on the structure and maybe the, how to record it, how to so it, was it, is it a discussion you think to interview somebody to, I don't know. But because possibilities are, you can perform a kind of interview to say some physician or some psychologist also, or you can discuss presenting, I don't know, some recent article about this, or you can impersonate two figures, one skeptical and one say, I don't know, this is up to you how to convey.
Yes, we were thinking about presenting the different sides of facts and myths about how it is happening during pregnancy in maternal brain, with me as performing the meat part and Giada performing the facts part, because we are involved in a research. We have also some personal data from our research, from what are the things that really happens during pregnancy, but still during a pandemic it was really clear in the papers, for example, that people have a lot of myths about what happens in mother pregnancy brain. So it may be we never did a podcast before, so probably it's not a good product, but
I think that you appreciate also the products that clearly are not the best, maybe for style. Eh? But when you try to do one, you start to appreciate a lot also the low-level one. But
okay.
So I think, remember that you have to produce something that stays in 50 minutes at most.
Yeah.
Which you will discover it is a very large time.
Giovanna? From my point of view, a chat between all you two are perfect. Is perfect, and okay. You can also use StreamYard just to record, and after that you can
also use Meet. Okay. I don't know if Meet still allows recording, but maybe Skype or other.
Or you can meet if you work in the same department. We don't know. So
I had already used StreamYard in May for a series of seminars on women's mental health. So we are just trained.
It's not very difficult, no?
No, StreamYard is quite good.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have
the second group at the moment. And you can really, it's the same for, I want just to say, for Nastase, for all of you, that it's not important now have the complete idea. You can work in a asynchronous way, and next time you can just give us
I suggested you to discuss now a bit, just because we are here now. So if you have to ask something, clearly we are always available, but here we are all together. Maybe if one want to ask to the other participant what they think of something and so on. Okay, let's pass to Andrea Ranfagni is here. Don't see him. Otherwise, Peroni or others who want to, Eugenio, Lorenzo Briccolani or Antonio Baldassare. So let me see. Clearly, you are not obliged to do anything. This is up to you. But I think that the occasion one can also produce something just by himself. So, who are you, Antonio?
Hi, professor. Hi to everyone. and was seeking for Andrea Ranfagni that proposed a very interesting topic about medical science fake news mm-hmm. that during these pandemics should be addressed also as an infodemic. Mm-hmm. And so I'm an occupational physician here at Careggi University Hospital. So every day we have to face this fake news in medicine about COVID, SARS-CoV-2, and many other things. So for me, it was a great idea by Andrea, and we still have to wait for him.
But do you have the mail of Andrea or not?
He left his email address and a Gmail address on...
Perhaps you can just try to...
Today, yes, of course. I'll send
otherwise, you can also have a chat with
he has also the classical UniFi address, andrea.ranfagni@unifi.it. So if you...
Okay, sure.
So this is you are walking while speaking. Be careful not to crash into some hole. No, but for one possibility is also that of using simply a phone, because one can also produce a video simply go somewhere and interview.
Just thinking, for example, for Facebook or Instagram, because, you know, we can also think about the media we want to use for our message.
Let us know if you are able to contact Andrea.
Stella. Yeah, I'll try.
Okay, you can try to write also to his standard UniFi address. Okay, so
there is also Lorenzo Bricolani and Tecla Gabrielli mm-hmm. that proposed a video presentation.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hi everybody, I'm Tecla. And yes, we have proposed a video presentation regarding unphysicist system paradox. In particular, we would like to do or something regarding teleportation or APR. The other one was proposed by Lorenzo, but then we decide to remain in the quantum physics, let's say. So I have see that another boy, Daniele, is interested in it, and I have read it now. So yes, of course, you are welcome in our group. And the other lady are not able to attend anymore the course, so will not participate with us. And we are not still decided yet how we can do it. My idea was maybe that we can try to do a video with draw. So maybe I can draw something while I explain the subject. But we are also open to other suggestions, also from Daniele, of course. And then we would like to do a video for a YouTube video, I don't know, something like that.
Have you seen the physics in the quarter of page, the videos produced by the former students, I think 2 years ago? If you go to...
Which one? I like 2 minute physics.
Yes.
I don't know if you are, something like that. You talk about.
Fisica in un quarto di pagina. Okay. It should be on YouTube.
Yeah.
Or you can find it in on the YouTube, there are too many entries for physics. Eh? If you go to comunicazione scienza, the site of this course. You see the screen now?
Yeah, yeah.
Here.
No,
year before, I think. This one. Some student developed this format, which is, say, one that can be seen.
Salve a tutti e benvenuti a questa nuova rubrica intitolata Fisica, un quarto di pagina alla volta, dove vi raccontiamo la fisica nascosta dietro oggetti di uso comune, appunto, un quarto di pagina alla volta. Io sono Alberto e in questa prima puntata vi parlerò di...
It's very nice. Yeah.
Just to see that one can do a lot of interesting point, interesting to shows using very poor.
I was thinking about Apiar Apiar paradox because we are actually in three, so one of us can be apart. So Eve, Alice, and Bob, but of course.
Yes, clearly, if Daniele says here in the chat that he doesn't know anything about teleportation, so clearly, and Daniele could be the, say, who ask questions and the other could answer or something like this.
Yes, it's a good idea, I think.
So if they're able to explain you, probably they're able to explain everybody. And have a look to other products. Minute physics is difficult. We tried to do this, and it is quite difficult to grow things. So clearly, there are softwares that emulates the real drawing, because really it is not so easy. Essentially, because you have to find a very good illumination. Because otherwise it comes out something very, very bad. Maybe it is a little easier on a blackboard, because the camera is not flashed as happens with the white board. So maybe you can try to draw something on a blackboard, but animations are not so easy.
Clearly, I can imagine.
Well, you can try, but I don't want you to waste too much time. Try. I think especially in this period in which you have to not to be in the same room and so on, it is even more difficult. Clearly, there are good examples of animations. I can show you one that I think it is very, very well done with this one. Let me show to share screen. So this is I don't know if you can see this.
Yeah, we can see.
Whether it's a lawnmower or a coffee pot, it has a home in our lives. Of course, our documents are no different. For years, they lived on our computers. Each person has their own computer.
But we tried to do, do you remember, Franco? And it was impossible.
Co-worker's computer home. Here's the home. You attach a document to an email, copies are created.
So this looks extremely easy. I can tell you this is not easy even.
Okay, so there is the other.
Okay.
That's okay. Thank you so much, Tecla. And if you need the help, we are here. also in the department think in Thursday and Friday, so, but if need something, otherwise you can just write us. There is some other voice singer that
Peroni suggested to study something about TikTok. Peroni, yes.
Is here?
Hi.
Okay, hi. Please.
Yes, and sorry for my bad English, but so I would like to study some function of TikTok to see if we can find a captivating form to be able to communicate something about experimental music or musical improvisation. That is my PhD research. And alternatively, I can record a video presentation about these topics, or there is no problem. I can work also alone, because I see there are a lot of scientists in this course, and I'm lucky to hear it.
I think that TikTok is surely a platform, so a channel to be explored. I never used it, and so I would like to know by you how can be used for communicating. I know that it is widely used by young people. My daughters, for instance, use a lot, so watch a lot of things that I don't understand, even the message on TikTok. So I think that it is interesting. I'm sorry that for the moment it looks you are alone. Maybe someone would like to join Ludovico to say to produce some. I think that you can just produce something on TikTok, just a small videos or something like this. I don't know. And then so comment or maybe present a comparison between your production and other things that can be related to science, communication science, or science of communication. And yes,
my
on TikTok.
My idea is to prepare a sort of simulation in my TikTok account or a video presentation. I don't know. How do you prefer? But what do you prefer?
I don't prefer anything. You are extremely free to do whatever you want. The important thing is to experiment and analyze what you have done in from a scientific point of view. So this can be useful, this channel or this method, this methodology or this way. Can be useful for this and this, maybe not. For instance, audio podcasts are not very useful when you want to present equations. But they can be listened while driving, and so it is used a lot by people which are doing other things, and so clearly. All channels have, in general, several characteristics that has to be analyzed. So who is using this channel? So if you want to reach young people, for instance, TikTok could be much better than using LinkedIn, which is essentially not known by any young people, I think. If you write an article, probably it is not read by a lot of young people. So
yes, I can work on it if it's possible, and I can work alone if
there
aren't anyone.
For instance, Adnan, are you thinking to do something? You want to join, for instance, Ludovico or I don't know, all the others
Hi.
Are already in.
Hi, Professor.
Adam, please, if you want.
Hello, Professor. Yes, I think the TikTok is a better idea to make something, but people are using for the comics or
TikTok is Chinese. They steal your data. Ciao Franco, sono Tommaso, Pecorella.
Sorry, my professor joined your class.
I know Tommaso.
He just came here. Mm-hmm. So yeah, unfortunately I'm from the engineering department, so we are rarely use such kind of applications, but normally we use to make documentation, but yeah, it's good way to make some presentation on a video or
I don't know if you want to.
I can try.
Join Ludovico. Maybe you can help with some technical support, and he can so contribute with the artistic contribution. I don't know. It is up to you. I don't want you to force anything.
No. Really. I love to learn things. I love to learn things. If you put me in a group, maybe it's better for me to learn from my colleagues.
Okay, so you have to self-administer. So okay, if you want to join Ludovico, Adrian, please be in contact, exchange organize a meeting and something. Is there anybody else who is not in a group or who wants to to change group or to have an help or discussion or so?
No. So we can use Zoom now for you have just half an hour.
Yeah, if you are self consistent, I mean you I think you can arrange yourself to discuss not using Zoom but using other kind of tools. So I can leave you so you can have this half an hour, this quarter, 3/4 of hour just to start working.
Okay, Franco, please don't close Zoom. No. So if someone...
No, I stay here.
Still here, okay? But you can just make your meeting without us now.
Yes, so, and if you want to have a private room here, I can open. Let me know. And so you are free. If you have questions, you can ask. If you want to to use Zoom for discussing, yes. Otherwise, you can join by yourself on other platforms. Remember that next Monday, if you are able, I would like you to present something or even only your trial, or if you have to show us something better. Okay? So if you are free, if you want to stay, okay. Otherwise, you can leave as you want. I stay here with Zoom open until 5, so you can also leave and join after if you want.
Sorry, Franco, se non vi vediamo entrare, perché magari stiamo facendo altre cose, mandateci una mail. Cioè, questo voglio dire, perché non è che siamo... Quindi a giovanna.pascini@unifi.it o franco.bagnoli@unifi.it, almeno vi vediamo, ecco. Scusate.
Ok, in any case, the Zoom, they have the link, Ok, so Giada e Claudia si trasferiscono subito.
Grazie di avercelo detto.
Ok, I think I can stop there.